Okay, here it goes. I am bald because
2,000 years later.
Guys, it's your boy, Tomorrow Washington, here with a fire video. You know, this is my first video, so everybody stay calm, stay chill, because, you know, more is coming up, you know. But, first things first, I'd like to tell you guys why I am bald, you know. Bald, you know, because a lot of people are asking me, why are you bald? What is the real reason? I tell them, like, I just ignore it, really, because I feel like it's really none of your business, but at the same time, you know, you might actually really want to know. So, here it goes. So, hold on, wait. Let me turn back on the music. All right, so, first things first, my name is Tamari Washington. If you didn't, if you haven't joined, the gang yet, the family, the Washington family, make sure that you guys like, comment, subscribe, turn on post notifications, so that so then when I post, you're the first one to watch it. Okay, so anyway, all right, let's focus. So, the real reason why I'm bald is, at the age of 7, my parents, actually it wasn't 7, I think it was 8. At the age of 8, my parents got divorced. It was very hard for me because I thought it was done. Like, I thought I was going to foster care. I thought it was over, you know. I thought my life was done, you know. So, I then, hold on. Oh shoot. So then, you know, I thought my life was over. I wanted my family to stay together, honestly. But, you know, not everything goes your way in life, you know. So when I wanted my family to stay together, but they didn't, unfortunately. So I can't say nothing about that. I want the perfect. Okay, so that's good. Okay, so then as I started growing up, you know, I had a whole lot of hair. Like, you see this? You see that? No, I'm just playing. I didn't have hair like that. So. I think I'll put a picture up right there what my hair looked like. But, what I look like with hair. But first, I had a lot of hair. Like, have you ever seen Deshae Frost, you know, or Deshae Frost, or Deshae Frost's brother? You know, I had hair like that. Like, it was super, like, you know, it was long, it was good, you know. It's nice hair, you know. Messed up hairline, of course, but it doesn't matter about that. But, really, it was hard for me. So, I started growing up, and I was still stressing. My hair started falling out everywhere, you know, and I got to wave level, you know, like when people get waves, beginner gets waves, and, you know, they want to get waves. My hair was like that, but it had spots everywhere. So my mom was like, what if you go bald? And I said, I was just so worried. I was like, I'm not going to have no friends. I'm not going to have no people that, you know, I'm going to be a loner. I'm going to be sitting at the table by myself. And I was just like, and really, I just wanted to cry, but, you know, I had to hold in my emotions for that. So, I got to second grade, you know. I knew a lot of people there already, you know. And I started, you know, I wasn't completely bald yet, but I still had, like, a little afro like this, you know. And then my mom, the second grade summer, my mom was like, what if you just go bald? So I just wanted to cry, you know. I went in my bed, I cried, you know. I did whatever, you know. But soon, I just had to get rid of it. You know, I can't have spots everywhere and be like, oh, it's okay. No, I couldn't. So I chose to go bald, you know. And I am bald now because Yeah, I chose to. So then as I started getting into sixth grade, you know, well, I'm gonna just tell you about my life as a bald man first, and then I'm gonna tell you what really happened. So I got into sixth grade, you know, well, no, I just skipped a whole bunch of grades. I got into third grade, you know, and I knew a lot of people there. Well, I didn't know a lot of people there, but I knew some people there. And, I actually knew nobody, but my mom was the principal, so everybody was cool with me, you know, I was cool with everybody. So then, you know, I started getting made fun of a little bit, but it was okay, because, you know, I didn't really care, you know. Once you get made fun of a lot, like, that was my first time, so, you know, I took it personal, you know. I was like, why would you even say something like that? Like, there's actually no point. Like, what if I do this? Guess you know I'm a winner. All right, so then I got into sixth grade, and most of the people from Rock Hill went to Denny, so I was okay, you know. I hang out with the people that were from Denny, you know, and I was cool with everybody. But really, the newcomers that I did not know, they were, why are you bald? Why you look like that? You're so, you know. And that was like a couple, you know, like whenever you get, you know, made fun of for like a couple of, you know, years, my 2 years getting made fun of, because I got third and then I got a sixth. And those were when I took it in so personal, I just wanted to cry. But, you know, I kept it in me, you know, and I was just like, it's whatever. So then, you know, a lot of people made fun of me. A lot of people wanted to touch my head. I didn't like it, you know. So whenever somebody used to go like this, they have their stomach open and bow. Wait a minute, stop. So then, you know, a lot of people did it anyway, but I wasn't tripping. Nah, I don't like that song. So then, really, I got into sixth grade, you know, a lot of people made fun of me. And then I got into seventh grade, and people that made fun of me, I just took it like, oh, yeah, because that was a funny guess, huh? That was supposed to be funny? I'm sorry. I forgot to laugh. Ah-ha-ha. But, you know, it wasn't really funny. It was kind of childish, like, ugh, you look bald. Like, how do I look bald?
Did you guys lose this game, or did the Jazz win this one?
Some people actually said stuff like that. I was just like,
bro, what are you talking about, man?
But then,
bro, I'm out, man. That nigga's tripping.
I got into seventh grade, you know, people still doing it, you know, still try to touch my head. Eighth grade, people still try to touch my head. And then I got into ninth grade, and people really, you know, they're like, oh, I know him. That's Deshaun's brother. Yeah. You know, I knew a lot of people there. So, you know, I didn't really, you know, I knew most of them. But, okay, so this is how I actually became bald. So, when my parents got divorced, I started stressing a lot. And that was, like, second grade. And you're too young to be stressed. You know, you're in second grade, don't stress. Life lesson. For real. All right, life lesson. Do not, and I mean do not stress, because whenever you stress, you're basically putting your life, you know, like, when you stress, you do things that you wish, I don't know, I don't really know, but when you stress, you come like this. You don't want that, I bet. So, but, really, yeah, you know, so my parents got divorced. It was second grade. I lost all my hair around fourth or fifth grade. I think all my hair was gone fourth or fifth grade, or probably even sixth. So I think it was around sixth grade, and, you know, I lost all my hair. And then, I started losing my eyebrows. Because in fifth grade, I had eyebrows, but not a whole lot of hair. I had patchy hair. And I lost my eyebrows, and now look like this. But, yeah, and then, I was bad. No, I'm on a different one. Alright, let me stop focusing on this music. Okay, the music is gonna play. Okay, so, yeah. I lost my hair because my parents got divorced. My parents got divorced. And then I came into fifth grade, and my uncle died. And then I came into seventh grade, or sixth grade, or no, I think it was seventh grade, and my papa died. And it was a lot of stressing because it's like, oh, it was like around fifth grade. It's like, oh, your uncle couldn't make it to your party. And I was like, why? And she was like, because he is in the hospital. He's not feeling well. And she was like, he's in a better place now, definitely. But I feel like it was just so sad. It was like, I can't take it. And then I got into seventh grade, and they were always like, your papa's not feeling good. And I loved him because you know what he did? It was like, we used to have everyone come over, right? The day before Christmas Eve. Because Christmas Eve, we have Christmas parties. A lot of people come over, you know, we celebrate, you know, we get some family time. Everybody comes, like, oh, we have over, like, 150 people in the house. So then, I'm like, my papa wakes up around 3 o'clock. He starts cooking. We wake up. The whole house is clean. First, the whole house is cleaned. He already cooked. He already cleaned. So I just woke up and was like, oh, I just gotta wait until this time. And then we eat. We get to eat. You know, so it was hard for me to see him go. You know, he taught me a whole lot, you know. And he also showed me how to, you know, be a better man. He's like a second dad to me. Yeah. What song is this? I literally just listened to this. Okay, but anyway. Yeah, he showed me a lot, so it was hard for me to see him go. But, yeah, so this disease is called alopecia. You get it by stressing a lot and your hair falls out. So, rule number one, do not stress. Take it easy. Life is gonna be okay. What is that song by Tupac? Every Little Thing? No, I don't think that's... I don't know who that is. I don't know who sings that song, but it's Every Little Thing? Oh, no. I think that's Bob Marley. Yeah, I think it is, okay. Every little thing is gonna be alright. Alright, and then there's another song by Tupac. I forgot what it's called. It's like... Yeah, I don't remember what the song's called. But, you know, I just remember that Bob Marley. Every little thing is gonna be alright. You know, I got those vocals. But, yeah. I stressed a lot. Lost a lot of hair. And now I'm bald. But thank you for watching the video. Hold on, wait. First thing, my name is Damari. Last name Washington. Like, comment, subscribe, turn on post notifications. So whenever I post, you are the first one to see it first. Also, hold on, wait. Let me get a thumbnail. No, let's not make that the thumbnail. Nah, that looks ugly now. Okay. Alright, I'm gonna do a crying tear right there. Alright, but stay tuned because I'm doing a giveaway. You guys wanna see what the giveaway is? Ha! Wait. Boy! Oh, yeah, I'm editing that. That's funny. But, yeah, stay tuned for the giveaway, all right? All right, stay tuned, stay blessed, live your best life, you know? And remember, it's be awesome. Just be you. Be you. I think that's the thing. Just be you. All right, I'm out of here. Peace.
Cause I'm getting money now, I know you heard that. Young nigga on the corner, bitch, I had to serve crack. Uncle fronted me some peas, had to get them birds back. We came up on dirty money, I gave it a bird back. Cut off the rain and I gave